Assalamu alaikum, dear young men and young women, dear brothers and sisters. Today I finished my journey to Africa, finishing 1 week and few hours in Nigeria, visiting Sokoto, Abuja, Lagos and Mina. These 7 or 8 days is confirming my idea. There's a solution in Africa, the solution in most of the countries that are visiting is to look down at agriculture industry and livestock. This is the basic industry that you can create. Does not need a lot of skills, especially at that time, now, and it can employ millions and millions and millions and millions of people in Africa, and actually to make them able to earn their living on a daily basis. Then we can develop the country at a later stage. What my message today, on the way from Lagos to Lome, the capital of Togo, before I land in the evening in N'Djamena, the capital of Chad, is you have to invest in agriculture industry, livestock, to enable you to create millions and millions and millions of jobs for the low-skilled people in this country and other countries. One country is that Allah has given it the source of water, good climate, and good land, such as Egypt, Iraq. Egypt has the River Nile. Iraq has Euphrates and Tigray. Ignore agriculture. They become depending on smaller countries who control them by trade and by export and import. The people who cannot produce their daily food ration are not independent. The country that does not produce its food is not an independent politically in making its own decision. So people might say that we have oil, we have gas. Yes, we have, but most of the oil extracted from Africa and other countries we don't have the refinery to refine it in our country. It goes to Europe and come back to us. It goes to Europe as a crude oil and come back to us. And the people who are benefiting it as a very highly skillful individuals from our country, and even most of the companies are in control of this oil and gas are foreign companies that control the economy of Africa and the economy of the Middle East as well. So, if we go back to the solution, as I mentioned, young men and young women, solution is under our feet. Very simple, it's local, and you can make it innovative. First step of finding a solution to these countries is to enable the individual and his family or their family to have the daily earning, have an income to sustain their life on a low basis. Then, with the time goes on, they can develop the society, they can create communities, they can cement the social infrastructure of the country and can build a stronger and able country. Somebody might say that, how about climate change? How about the rise of temperature? How about actual desertification in Africa and other places? I said, yes, it's happening. It's happening because of more than one reason. Reason number one is the ignorance of the citizen who keep cutting the woods without understanding that this wood is creating this oxygen that they breathe. Second, the corruption in the local government who are giving such land, which constitute hundreds of thousands of acres, to foreign investors to change it to lands, to cement blocks, and cut these woods, like what we see nowadays in Amazon, like what we see nowadays in Angola and in Congo and other places which are suffering from the fire which have been watching for the last few weeks. Corruption of the government on one side on a bigger scale. First is ignorance of the people. The third point is the reluctance of the major or the powerful or stronger countries of tackling the climate change, because tackling the climate change is a part of goodness, and leaving the climate to change and leaving this kind of pollution in the planet to happen is an act of evil. If we don't stand together to fight climate change, if we don't stand together to empower local community, local people on the basic stuff that they can produce to make their daily earnings, we are working against humanity, and we are working against the people who claim that would like to save their lives. In conclusion, young men and young women, I'm inviting you to come to Africa. I'm inviting you to become explorers. I'm inviting you to go everywhere to learn, to comprehend, to be able to make a change that humanity is waiting to see, whether on the level of the climate or whether on the level of empowering people in this country. God bless you, inshallah. I'll see you when we land in N'Djamena tonight, and from there, we can see you again. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.